But this is the great lie. Many are deceived by it. They've gone to the altar. They've prayed the prayer. They've recited it. They think this is salvation. They think that they are justified and they go home. Nothing changed. But Jesus said, not everyone that says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that does the will of my Father, which is in heaven. But is this not this what they teach you? That everyone that says, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven. That man by his works, by his action, by his will, is somehow justified. This is a deception. We know that in 2 John verse 8 it says, whosoever transgresses and abides not in the doctrine of Christ has not God. Whoso abides in the doctrine, he has both the Father and the Son. So those that do not abide in the doctrine of Jesus Christ are without God. They are separated from God. They do not speak for God. But it is Jesus Christ who said in John chapter 6, that no man can come to me except the Father which has sent me draw him. And yet they teach on you that man by his own coming, his own will, his own power is justified. They teach that man somehow.
Everyone can know that Jesus Christ is coming and coming back for those who live for him and obey his word, do what David in his life. The only one who's going to make it in. But God wants you to make it in. There was none to be lost because it's not his will and not his desire to none be lost. But God wants us all to have a chance. God is loving. God is faithful. God is forgiving. And God is merciful. And his goodness and mercy endures forever. And you go to heaven, you have nothing to lose. Because you put your trust in Jesus Christ. And you live for him. Are you trust and obey his word? So there's no way you can be left out. If you love Jesus, you will have eternal life. Don't give up on God, because he'll never give up on you. If he didn't love you, you would be here. You'd be lost. So it does not hurt to give Jesus Christ a try. Because he is full of love and compassion. He is full of kindness. Every part of him is love and kindness. We can be exactly like him, or we can practice his ways. God is good all the time. And we're not good, and we mess up, we do things wrong, he's still good to us. He still loves us. He loves us all, no matter what we do, he loves us. Not going to stop loving us. Give Jesus Christ a try. You have nothing to lose. He wants to open your eyes here and now, show you that he wants you to go that way. He wants to see you make it. He died for your sins, and he rose from death. Give Jesus Christ a try. You have nothing to lose. Get to know him. That's the more important thing. Get to know Jesus. Don't give up. You do, don't give up. Peace be with you. God be with you. God is good.
He is.
Yeah. You know something? We all have to stand before God.
It's only by grace that we abide in his will. It's only by his power. It's It's only by Christ coming to live within us and rescue us from our own evil. Like man loves evil, runs towards evil.
He loves darkness.
If in bondage, Christ is able to give us freedom more than just what we do for him. It's what he does for us. Mm-hmm. In the poverty of man, the evil of man.
What we do him is for the show.
It's God who works in you, but the women to do of his good pleasure.
No, I'm saying that's you. And what we do for him is for the show. So that would be a problem. What I would get there.
The world has passed away. Every
pregnant child will be saved. How very little of that is wrong. And you know that with the God. So you will fight. And you'll be two. And you will fight. Two will turn to three. You will fight by muscles. Separated from God, not willing to obey God, not willing to follow Jesus. We're in need of Jesus Christ to come and to break down our own ungodly ways, to remove from us the stony heart, and to give unto us a heart of flesh that we may obey his commands. We're in need to be saved from ourselves, from our own wicked heart that rebels against God. No man is able to justify himself by his own works, by his own deeds, by his own righteousness. It is the Lord who has said, all our righteous deeds are as filthy rags. As filthy rags. Furthermore, in Romans chapter 3, it says, there's none righteous. No, not one. There's none that doeth good. There's none that understands. There's none that seeks after God. And yet all the religions of the world have one thing in common. They teach that man is basically good. That man is able to will good. And that doing so, he is pleasing God. But it says in the scriptures, without faith, it is impossible to please him. Without faith, it is impossible to please him. That man is justified by faith, by the faith of Christ, and not by the works of the law. Only by looking unto him, only by looking unto Jesus Christ and him crucified, can a man be set free from all his righteous deeds. And that's more than wickedness and rebellion. The Bible teaches that the carnal mind, the natural mind, is an enmity against God because it is not subject unto the law of God, nor indeed can be, so that those that are in the flesh cannot please God. But man born naturally is unable to please God, unwilling to follow God, unwilling to turn himself to righteousness or holiness. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace. This is the reason that he died. The reason that Christ died was because of our wickedness, because of the evil of the human heart, not for our goodness. Jesus said, I've not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. But sinners. This is a faithful saying that Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners. We need only confess what we are, to understand the true nature of our heart and our desperate need of a Savior. And yet without Jesus Christ, you are in a desperate situation. You're in need of a new birth. You're in need of someone to pay for your sins. It says the wages of sin is death. Blood is required. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Blood is required. As Jesus approached John the Baptist, his words were, behold, the Lamb of God, which takes away the sin of the world. Jesus Christ, the only righteous sacrifice, the only holy one. Jesus said, do not think that I've come to destroy the law or the prophets. I've not come to destroy, but to fulfill. Jesus Christ is the fulfillment of the law. When all of us, like sheep, have gone astray, all of us have rebelled against his commands. The Bible says that
sin is a transgression of the law. It says further, if any man stumble at any one point in the law, he's guilty of the whole law, which requires death or perfect holiness. But Jesus Christ, as a lamb without spot, without blemish, Jesus Christ comes as the fulfillment of the law for a people. A people that, who by grace should believe on him. Trusting in our own faith and not the faith which is of God. The faith which is the gift of God, which comes by hearing him. Through his word, Jesus said, he that commits sin is a slave of sin, and the slave does not abide in the house forever, but the Son abides forever. If the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. But where can a man find this freedom? Jesus said, if you continue in my word, then you are my disciples indeed, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. That man may obtain freedom through hearing the word of God. That the scriptures have been given, which are able to make one wise unto salvation, that man is able to find in them eternal life. As Jesus said, is it spirit that gives life? The flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. The words of Jesus Christ, they are life. They are where a man can find freedom from his own heart. They are where a man can find a knowledge of God, a saving knowledge of God. Conversion is necessary. Jesus said, except a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Man must attain to this new birth, or else he will meet the second death. Man is in a perilous condition, separated from God, without Jesus Christ, only by looking to him, the only name given among men whereby we must be saved, only by looking unto Jesus Christ, his righteous sacrifice, Jesus Christ, and him crucified, not of works of righteousness which we have done, not our own religious affections or duties, but only by looking unto Jesus Christ and him crucified. It is only by the blood of the Lamb of God, only by the sacrifice of God, that man can be justified. By the works of the law shall no flesh be justified in the sight. Those who seek by good deeds to be justified in the sight of God, seek by good deeds to enter the kingdom of heaven. It is only through a new life that is found when Jesus Christ comes to live within you. Not an empty faith, not believing on a book, but a real living presence of God coming to live within you, setting you free, opening your eyes to the truth of God, giving you a new life. And this gift is upon the very worst of us. It says in the book of Corinthians that God has chosen the weak things of the world to put to shame the things which are strong. God has chosen the foolish things. The things which are nothing has God chosen to bring to nothing the things that are. That no flesh should glory in his presence. The very worst among us. This is a faithful saying that Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners. The worst among us. For those that are empty and carrying heavy burdens, Jesus Christ has life for you. He said, I've come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Is this the life you walk in, a more abundant life? Come without money, come and buy, he said. Come to the waters of life and drink freely without price. There's a true saying when Jesus said, you will not come to me that you might have life. Man is unwilling to come on his own. His words must pierce your heart. You must come to know the emptiness of a life without God, being separated from God, and enemies in your mind through wicked works. The Bible says in Jeremiah 17 that the heart of man is desperately wicked and deceitful above all things. Who can know it? Man is in a perilous condition. He loves evil. That he pursues lust and sin. Man is in need of a Savior. That Savior is Jesus Christ the Lord. This is the reason that God, he said, I lay down my life that I might take it again. No man takes it from me, but I lay it down of myself. It was laid down for the sins of man, for the wickedness of man. as we, who have gone astray and rebelled against God, being separated and alien, native, they might reconcile us to God by his own death on the cross. But can't you hear us as the Spirit of God pleads with you, being reconciled to God? It is only by looking unto Jesus Christ and him crucified that you can find the reconciliation, that man can attain to atonement, to be brought back to God. The Bible says, by one man sin entered into the world, and death passed upon all men, for that all had sinned. So there is no man that is born in the state he must be in. But you must be born again to see the kingdom of God. The way we're born is not good enough. You're in need of a new birth, a spiritual birth. Jesus said, except a man is born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the Spirit is spirit.